Greetings. There once was a man. This man lived in a culture which taught there was one true Allah. He believed in his Allah and loved his Allah. As he prayed one night, his Allah spoke to him. I want you to obey me. Yes, Lord, I love you. I will obey you. I will submit to your will, O God. I want you to go. And his God told him to go to a distant land. But Lord, in that distant land, they do not believe in you. And they may kill me when they learn I follow a different God. That is the cost of following me, Hizillah said. And so the man prepared himself and packed his things and left for the land. Many days passed in his journey of obedience, of submission to the will of his God. And as he was passing through an isolated place, he came across another man. Hello, friend, the man said. My God has told me to travel and teach others of him. I already have a God, the stranger answered. But the Allah I speak of is the one true Allah. I already follow the one true Allah, the stranger said. The God that I follow is the maker of heaven and earth, said the traveler. The Allah I follow is the maker of heaven and earth and all the worlds, the stranger answered. The God I follow asked me to submit to his will and come tell you about him. The Allah I follow commands me to submit and obey him. So what? The God that I follow sent his only son to reveal his father, said the traveler. That cannot be, said the stranger. The Allah I follow has no son. Did your Allah tell you this himself? No, he sent the prophet to tell us, the greatest and last prophet ever. And did your Allah tell you this himself either? No, the prophet of Allah told us for Allah. Allah is most wise. If he spoke to many, it would cause war. The Son of God wants you to know he loves you. Allah has no son. You commit blasphemy. Do not do it again. I must obey my God and his son, my friend. And I must obey my Allah. I am submitted to his will. And what does submission to your Allah compel you to do? If you blaspheme against Allah or his prophet, I may kill you. In fact, I must kill you. I know, brother. And I told that to God and his son when he told me to come. You have blasphemed again. I will not warn you any more. My God told me not to fear death, brother. The Son of God has conquered death and the grave. And the stranger attacked him and killed him, shouting, His Allah is greater, as he did. The cost of following the one true God and his Son is that you may lose your life on earth. Matthew 10:39. Anyone finding his life will lose it, and anyone losing his life because of me will find it. Matthew 16:25. If you try to hang on to your life, you will lose it. But if you give up your life for my sake, you will save it. John 12:25. Anyone who loves their life will lose it, while anyone who hates their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Revelation 12:11. They have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they did not love their lives so as to shy away from death. The Son of God has come to bring us eternal life because he himself has conquered death. Colossians 2:13. When you were dead in your trespasses and in the uncircumcision of your sinful nature, God made you alive with Christ. He forgave us all our trespasses. Having canceled the debt listed against us in the decrees that stood opposed to us, he took it all away, nailing it to the cross. Having disarmed the rulers and the authorities, he made a show of them in public, having triumphed over them in it, in the cross. Revelation 1:18. I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. and have the keys of hell and of death. The Son of God is he who was dead and is now alive forevermore. And he, the Son of God, has taken the keys to hell and the grave. I titled this video The Parable of the Two Costs, and so far I have only mentioned one cost, the cost of losing your life to follow the Son of God. The other cost is living, and yet losing your family and friends and culture. Matthew 19:29, and everyone who has left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or fields for the sake of my name will receive 100-fold and will inherit eternal life. Mark 10:29, truly I tell you, Jesus replied, no one who has left home or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or fields for me and the gospel will fail to receive 100-fold in the present age, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and fields, along with persecutions, and to receive eternal life in the age to come. I believe this may be the harder cost to face and to swallow. If you call yourself Muslim, you know this in your heart. If you were to allow yourself to question the prophet, and if you were to find the real God of Abraham, your submission to the real God of Abraham may cause you to have to reject Islam and the prophet. And doing so will cost you mother and father and brothers and sisters and home and even country. But the Son of the one true God has said this is the upfront cost of submission to the one true God. But the reward from the one true God is eternal life with him. The message of the true gospel teaches you to give up your life in love to share the truth with others. The first cost is the willingness to die presenting the truth to strangers, those who may kill you for doing so. Whole countries exist where to share the truth is to face death and torture and beheading. The second cost is the willingness to give up all that you hold dear and important in this life, and yet continue to live in obedience to the one true God and his Son. May the Holy Spirit speak to your heart and encourage you to be willing to face, and if necessary, pay both costs. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.